We're based out of Geraldton on the west coast of Australia. We operate one big boat at the Abrolhos Islands. The history is wrapped around four brothers. We're a family company. When we were very young, just all out of school, we all went and became fishermen. One of the brothers found some scallops at the islands and we started from there.
The Abrolhos Islands is a series of 102 islands and reef systems, and it's quite an unusual environment because it's a mix of temperate and tropical species, and particularly in the marine environment. It's an area of really high diversity and quite important in terms of ecological values.
The saucer scallop, it's one of the sweetest scallops out there. It's a swimming scallop. When it's scared by a predator, it gets up and swims. We don't use dredges or anything like that. We actually catch it with nets, wait for it to jump, and then we catch it.
I've done multiple surveys for the Fisheries Department over 30 years, and we help them with their research, and we help them measure the product.
100. 95, 105, 103, 94.
Our method of fishing at the islands is very low impact on the bycatch, and so we actually wanted to prove it, put some actual real hard data out there.
It's really a co-management arrangement in terms of the way that we work with the fishers. They also assist in terms of the collection of the data for stock assessment. They provide a vessel to do our surveys. So for every site that was sampled, the trawl nets go down for 20 minutes and are then retrieved. The boats tow two nets in this fishery, and one side was retained and put in a box and brought back to the laboratory here in terms of species identification and weighing. The other side was weighed into broad groups so that you can have a look at comparison in terms of bycatch to catch kind of ratios.
With the intervention of things like turtle exclusion devices, which is a big device that actually deflects any big creature out of the net that might happen to get caught in it, even any stingrays or anything like that is pushed through an opening in the net at the top of the net, and we don't actually see them anymore. We've worked for years to actually eliminate any big predators, sponges, weed, anything that we want out of the net, because we don't want to take that either. It's hard to deal with. We did experiments with even putting panels of larger mesh in certain pockets to release small scallops for our own advantage. So we're always working every year on any new development that comes up. We've tried to implement it to keep us right at the head of the pack of sustainability.